Loves, welcome back to my channel and welcome to another favorites. This is my second ever favorites of 2020. Today I will be showing you all of my makeup favorites and there will be another video where I'll show you my skincare and some random favorites. So yes, past 3 months I have not been to any party, no festive occasions, no gatherings as such, and no outing at all, zero outing past 3 months. So where was I wearing my makeup in my house filming videos as usual. And yes, I felt these 3 months I have used my makeup properly, and during these 3 months only I have learned more about my base, and I have learned to a level where I could see a major difference in my base itself. Like earlier I could see my facial hairs, or I could see some of the imperfections by myself itself, but now I feel I have nailed it to an extent and I do feel good about my base when I'm filming. Even if I'm not filming, I do like seeing my base makeup. So yes, during these 3 months I did learn a lot and I did use a lot of different steps and a lot of different type of makeup, and I didn't buy these makeup separately to achieve this base. It is that they were already there in my vanity and I never happened to use them, and kabhi kabhar yaad aaya to I would have picked it up and used it, but these 3 months I have used them and I feel these products are amazing and why I was not using them, and they work so well on my skin. And yes, now I know the purpose of these products, why people use them. So yes, here I am with some interesting makeup favorites of mine, and yes, you will definitely learn during this process how these products have become my favorites. And yes, I will be leaving down everything in my description if you want to grab anything for yourself. Don't buy everything what I show you in my favorites, because not everything is meant for everyone and you really don't need multiples of anything. If you already have something like that, buy another brand, you are good to go. So let's get started and find out what all products have made it to my favorites. Since I already told you that I have learned so much about my base makeup, there are too many products from the base category. The first product which comes into my hand is a primer by Sugar, the Sugar Base of Glory Pore Minimizing Primer. Silicone base, super light, pore minimizing, and it gives you nice luminosity even if you happen to wear a matte foundation. So yes, this is an absolute stunning primer. And the second one is the Maybelline Master Prime by Face Studio, a cream finish primer which is more on a stickier side, which really helps your foundation to settle in and gives you a smoother base. All in all, I love to pour the primers a lot, and you happen to see a lot of my tutorials on Instagram and YouTube, you would have seen that I have used these two primers a lot. And practically speaking, this one is almost done. I am going to repurchase this soon. So if you're eyeing two good primers, yes, you can definitely give a shot to these. Since we are all about base, the second product which I'm absolutely loving is by Falabella Skin Spotlight Illuminating Lotion. It's very close to the MAC Strobe Cream in the shade Pink Light. I have that one also, but frankly speaking, I'm using this every time I do my base. Every time. I just love the finish of this, and it sits perfectly on my primer and really give me that nice luminosity which is happening on my face. There is way too much of luminosity happening on my face, but then natural luminosity is happening because of this. I apply this all over my face just like a normal moisturizer on top of my primer, and I'm good to go. It really sits well onto my skin. So if you're eyeing something like this, you can include this one. And the second product which I absolutely love putting nowadays is a liquid highlighter onto my high points of my face, the nose and all, underneath my foundation, so that even if I don't put a highlighter, I can still see my face glowing, like the natural glow can happen. So if you want to have that within glow and to give extra glow with the extra highlighter, then you see the highlighter is like booming. This is something which you should add to your foundation routine or your face base routine. And frankly speaking, these two products, there's only one person who has made me use it regularly, is Debashree. I happen to see a lot of her recent tutorials on Instagram and her pictures and her YouTube videos where she happened to use this kind of a highlighter a lot. I was eyeing the Nykaa one. I will get that soon. But I thought the one which I have, I will use that first. And I must tell you, use this. You will fall in love with a liquid highlighter because the liquid highlighter gives you a very nice subtle glow. When the sun hits your face, it just like it's there, like, you know, it reflects in a very natural way if the foundation is laid on top of it. And if you put your additional highlighter, it just gives you that nice high definition finish. So yes, these two products, I'm totally obsessed. I can go on and on with these two, but yes, I never used to use these products. Once in blue moon, I used to pick them up and use it. But past 3 months, almost I would say past 2 months, I have been using these constantly. Every time I do my makeup, I will definitely use these products. Recently, I have tried a lot of new products. One of the product is Sugar Cosmetic Orange Corrector. Today also, I have used this corrector. This is a proper orange corrector. If you're eyeing one orange corrector, or for that matter, a corrector stick in green or peach or contour stick, go for the sugar ones. They are well made. They are made to perfection. I have blush stick also, I have the contour stick also, but this one I'm showing you because from the time I've got it, I've been using this constantly because of one reason. Firstly, my face doesn't need an orange corrector. It's very difficult to cover up this orange corrector when I'm using it because it shows up if I don't go in with like the second or the 2.5 layer of foundation on my face, at least the mouth area where I put this corrector, because it's way too deeper for my skin, because my skin doesn't have any kind of pigmentation or darkness or even around my mouth. It's only my facial hair which I like to cover up with this because it really cancels out that upper lip hair. So yes, I have been loving this. I do use this around my mouth area. That's it. You just need like tad bit of product and you are done. You don't need too much. I think once you start using this one, you will stop using any other orange corrector you have because it's very easy to use and you need very little product and it does the job and it doesn't mix up with your foundation and change the color of your foundation. So if you feel you need one corrector, invest in here. It's good. Moving ahead, foundation. Yes, I did use a lot of different foundation, but these two foundation in particular I have used the most. The first one is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. The reason of me using this foundation a lot is that I want to finish this foundation. At least by end of this year, I want to finish this foundation because I want to repurchase it. Agar repurchase hi kareedna hai, toh why do I want to finish it off? Because har cheez ki expiry hoti hai and I don't want to use this foundation after it is expired. So yes, it still has a lot of time. It has almost 1 year. So I am keeping a target of December so that I have enough time I can use this foundation. I'm already being done with this foundation, half a bottle. So I think only a little bit is left now. I'm wearing this foundation today. I really like the finish of this foundation. It is medium to full coverage. I have gone 2 layers of this foundation today on my skin because I wanted a full coverage. So yes, if you're eyeing a good, affordable, high-end, full coverage foundation, go for the Wet n Wild one. I'm in the shade Beige Amber. Amber beige. So yes, this is a stunning foundation again, not because I want to finish it off. I showed it to you because I love the foundation and I would like to repurchase. That is why I want to finish the older bottle first. Moving on to another interesting foundation, which doesn't seem to be a foundation for me, but I like to mix this foundation with a lot of my other foundation, and I recently did a review video also on this foundation, is the Sugar Drop the Base Serum Foundation. The only reason of me loving this one is that it really makes my other matte foundation a little more skin-like, a little more easy blendable foundations. Like Maybelline Superstay is Superstay foundation and it is thick, it's matte. So this mixed with that foundation gives a really nice, you know, skin-like finish, but a full coverage foundation. I like to mix this foundation with my Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define, or Conceal and Define foundation, if I'm not wrong. Again, that foundation is a super thick, super full coverage foundation. This foundation mixed with that one gives a really nice base. So I really like to mix this foundation with a lot of my other foundation. By itself, it's not a foundation for me. I cannot wear it. But yes, I have been enjoying this as a mixing portion with my other foundation. So yes, this had to be my favorite because, as I said, I have learned a lot during these 3 months. And these are small techniques I have learned during these 3 months. Since we have done so much to our face till now, obviously I have to set my face. So to set my face, these are the two powders I have been using a lot. One of it is the Faces Canada Altime Pro HD powder. Again, stunning powder, well made. If you're eyeing this one, this is for $7.99. It is expensive, I totally get it, but for the quality you are not paying much. I feel it's a wonderful HD powder which gives you a tad bit of coverage also while you are putting it on your face. So you have to really get your right shade or else you can go wrong with it. But yes, it does give a little bit of coverage. It really fixes up everything and it gives you a very flawless base. Today I'm wearing this powder all over my face and I absolutely love the finish of it. And during this hot weather, it has really kept my makeup intact. It's almost 4 to 5 hours and it's still in place. So absolutely loving this powder. I have been constantly using this and you can see the condition of the powder. It's almost done. I will hit pan on this powder very soon. So yes, this is something which I'm absolutely loving by Faces Canada. The second setting powder which I absolutely loved using is the Maybelline Fit Me Loose powder. Stunning powder. I really don't have to talk too much on it. I recently bought the K-Beauty one also. That is also absolutely stunning powder. Obviously, that's something which I'm really enjoying recently, but just because I have bought that one, that cannot just make it to my favorites. Way too early to include a new product to my favorites. This one I'm using dedicatedly past 3 months and I cannot just pass this away just because I got something new. But this one works very good. Today also I have done a little bit of baking underneath my eye and just brushed it off. Good to go. If you suffer from too much of sweaty under eye or creasy eyes, or you feel that your eyes do dry out faster, then I would suggest you not to bake your under eye too much. Just go in like for 5 to 10 seconds and then brush off gently. Because if you over bake your under eye, you may feel the powder has settled into your fine lines or your sweat has just taken a little powder and just settled in. So avoid baking if you feel all these things happen underneath your eye. Just take the powder, take it with a blender and just press it and remove the excess and you're good to go. That's how I do it underneath my eye and it stays on. So yes, if you're eyeing a good quality Fit Me powder is the one you can go for. As I said, it's the cult powder, one of the best affordable loose powders in drugstores. So why not just get one? Now before I start showing the next product, I must tell you one thing that yes, you happen to see a lot of these products, but I tell you girls, more than your eyes, if you spend a little extra time on your base, your eye and your base when comes together looks absolutely perfect and you will actually start loving your makeup more. So saying all that, let's move on to the next base product is blush. Yes, I did buy a lot of blushes, I did try a lot of brushes, but these two blushes in particular I have worn the most. The first one is the L'Oreal Paris Le Bar blush in the shade 10 Play With Me. This is how it is. I've done a full review on these products on my channel. This is a very stunning blush. Today I'm wearing it on my face. It looks very light in the pan, but on the face it looks just like this. You can build it to a more deeper shade if you want to, but yes, if you are of my skin tone or lighter than me, grab this one. If you are deeper than me, then there are more shades available, you can grab those. But I absolutely love this blush by L'Oreal. This is my first ever blush by L'Oreal and I must say they make some amazing blushes. So I was never a blush girl and I happen to use a lot of blush now, and this is something very new and something very unique into my collection as a blush formula. It's the Faces Canada Altime Pro HD Blush Light Camera Blush. This is how it is, quite mouthful name. This is how the blush looks like. The one factor about this blush is that this blush has a nice sheen happening. So it's not a proper matte blush. It has a little satin or like that shimmer effect to it. But once you place it on your face, you don't feel that you applied something shimmery. It's more of a matte blush which has a little sheen to it, which is not overpowering, and it's not going to give you any kind of texture on your cheeks. But if you have a textured skin, then avoid putting this kind of a brush, because these kind of blushes can accentuate your texture. But all in all, I absolutely love wearing this blush. Recently, a lot of you happened to ask, which blush are you wearing? Which blush are you wearing? And this is the one which I was wearing in most of my videos, because I absolutely love the finish of it. And nowadays, I'll just look for some glow. And this blush give me that glow. This is one of the uniquest blush I have in my whole blush collection. And I really, really enjoy putting this on my face. So if you're eyeing something like this, you can get one for yourself. I got these two products by Faces Canada in buy one get one, so I happen to pay only 50% of the amount. So yes, wait for such offers. So you really don't have to pay $7.99. You can get like two of the products in $7.99. Since a lot of glow is happening already, a highlighter is a must. Now yes, today's highlighter is something which is cult and everybody loves it, is the Maybelline Master Chrome Highlighter in the shade Golden, Molten Gold. This is a highlighter which I think you should definitely buy or get it, because if you have not tried this highlighter, you are really missing something in your life. If you are a makeup junkie, if you love doing makeup, then get something like this. It is affordable, it is drugstore, and you will just love it. If you want to glow like this, you get the glow here. This is something which you should get it if you're an Indian skin tone. And this shade in particular, firstly when I bought, I thought I will never wear this, but when I got it, I got obsessed with it. So yes, this is something which you should definitely buy and definitely try. I have been constantly wearing this highlighter. Oh my god, I cannot count the number of times I've worn it, because I wear it almost every time I do my makeup. I love to touch that highlighter. It's just made for me. Talking about highlighters, there's another highlighter which I have been loving the most, is the Sol Body Highlighter. Now, I never thought I would love this highlighter so much, but since I have become a highlighter junkie and I love putting highlighters, this is the one which I'm wearing a lot nowadays. Again, this I'm wearing on this side of my face. Now the camera doesn't pick up this side of my face, I don't know why, but yes, this is again a very beautiful highlighter. If you're looking for something like this, this is huge, and something which you can actually wear it on your body also, you will love it. This is something which I have been wearing a lot, and the reason of me wearing this a lot is also one that, as I mentioned earlier, that there are a lot of makeup which I have forgotten about, or I have just bought it, used it once and kept it aside and stopped using it. So this I happened to see one day and I was like, why am I not using this? And then I started using it and I got obsessed with it. So yes, this is something which I'm really, really loving. I'll just give you a swatch if you want. This is how it is. See, it's very body-like, but you can build it. When you put it on your face, it's there. It's like, boom, highlighter. You applied a highlighter. So yeah, if you're eyeing this one by Sol, get it. This is like a collector's highlighter. You should definitely have some pieces like this in your vanity. So those were the interesting face products I have been loving the most past 3 months. Let's move on to some eye and lip products. The first two products which I happen to use the most in combination are the two mascaras. Now I have learned past 2 months that if you combine two different mascaras of two different families, like a voluminizing mascara from a brand, a lengthening mascara from a brand, use them together, you see your lashes going way better than when you were using only one kind of mascara. So this idea, I happened to get it from YouTube only, and I thought, let me just try it. And once I tried it, I loved it. So the first mascara which I love using the most is the Maybelline the Hypercurl Volume Express mascara. And with the combination, this one, I use the Volume Million Lashes L'Oreal mascara. Now they both are volume mascaras, but since the bonds are different, the brands are different, the formula is different, they work pretty different. If you use this mascara, you get a little different result. You use this, you get a different result. But when you use together, you get more volume in your lashes and you get lengthening also simultaneously. So yes, today also I'm wearing these two mascaras together. That's how I'm using my mascaras nowadays. I like to mix two of the mascaras and then achieve that nice wispy lashes without putting any kind of false lashes. You know, I'm not a false lash girl. I don't like to put false lashes. I'm more of a mascara person. So yes, I love to put these two together, and by themselves also they are really good. If you're eyeing them separately also, you can get them. They could really nice volume to your lashes. But I love to put them together. Try this technique, you're going to love it. Another eye product which I'm loving the most, and you would have seen me using this product in most of my tutorials, is the Sugar Eye Dead Uso Metallic Eyeliner in the shade Bronze Horseman. Lovely, stunning shade. It's more of a gold bronze, not too high on bronze, not too high on gold. Wait, I'll show you a little close up. So this is how the shade looks like. Again, a stunning eyeliner. If you're looking for a metallic eyeliner, this is the one to go for. Because the formula on these eyeliner is up-notch, they show up on the eyes and it's easy to apply. So that is why I'm loving this eyeliner a lot past 2 months. Now before we jump on to the final segment where I show you my favorite lipsticks and lip liners, let's move on to some eyeshadow palettes. Now yes, past 3 months I realized when I was decluttering my makeup and when I was just cleaning up my makeup that there are so many eyeshadow palettes I have, but I don't use them. And there are some interesting palettes which I happen to buy just because I love the color scheme and I have hardly used them. So I took out few of the palettes and I started using them. Now in this process I did try a lot of palettes, but these three in particular I felt I have used the most out of all the palettes I've used past 3 to 4 months. The first one is the Nykaa Just Wink It palette in the shade Double Chocolate Chip, which I'm wearing today also on my eyes. Solely this palette I'm wearing on my eyes. Again, a stunning palette by Nykaa. If you are eyeing a good quality drugstore palette, go for the Nykaa Just Wink It palettes. Yes, they are $1,499, but nowadays you get these palettes flat 40 to 35% off. So you end up paying less than 900 rupees and you get one palette. And for the shades, you are paying a good money. As in like, if it is 900, it is worth 900. If it is 1400, it is worth 1400, I would say. Because the shadow quality is really, really, really good. So if you're eyeing one good drugstore palette, go for the Nykaa Just Wink It. And I have another variant, Sweet Sunday, but from the time I've got this one, I've been using this constantly because this is my kind of palette. This is me, this is bronzing geek. So yes, absolutely stunning, I love it. Today I'm wearing this palette on my eyes and I love my look. The other two palettes which I have are from my favorite brand, ColourPop. Now yes, I have a lot of ColourPop palettes. There's no end to it and I still want to buy more. But yes, I have made a promise to myself in the initial 2020 that I would not be buying more than 10 palettes during this year. So I have kept that promise with me and I see myself doing pretty well on it, like extremely well on it. So yes, I picked out few of my older palettes which I was not using. One of them is the Good Sport palette by ColourPop. Now, frankly speaking, I never planned to buy this one. I bought this one just because Antariksha happened to show this one in her favorites. And I thought if she said it's favorite, that means there is something about this. So I got this one. And I must tell you, this is a stunning palette. If you start working with this palette, you will love this palette more. And you can achieve some interesting looks with it. And I must tell you, whenever I have done a look with this palette, a lot of times people have come back and asked me, your eye look is real, looking really good, very nice makeup, all that compliments I happen to get. Because sometimes, I would say whenever I have done a look with this palette, it has always tended out with my usual looks. Like it's warmer, but it's not that typical warmer look. it is something out of the box. The recent look I did with this palette was in my K Beauty review. That day I wore this palette on my eyes and a lot of you said your eye look is looking very good. More than the reviews, everybody was interested into my eye look. So thank you for the compliments. But yes, this palette is stunning. If you're eyeing this one, I think you should get it. Don't have second thoughts in your mind, because camera doesn't do justice with the shadows, I must tell you. When you see the shadows, now you feel this has some amazing shadows. Like, frankly speaking, this particular green gold is something very different. I don't have this shade in any of my palettes. This gold, it may look a gold now to you, but when you see it in person, you see a lot going on in that gold. This purple, it looks very purple, but it has a lot of pink, it has a little blue tones to it, which really makes it a different shade altogether. So all in all, if you're eyeing this by Colourpop, get it. I really don't know if it is available or not, but this is the one which I've been using a lot. And last but not the least is a palette which I personally ordered on Colourpop site. I did get it delivered to my sister-in-law's place and she got it for me because I really wanted this palette, because I was like, ye to meri zindagi ka one of the best palettes hoga and I will use it. But I must tell you girls, once you start buying way too much of makeup and you keep buying na, it's impossible for you to use everything you have. So that is why I've restricted myself of not buying eyeshadow palettes for some reason, because I feel I have enough. I should use them first and buy accordingly. Obviously, I will never stop buying. So like recently, I just bought one palette, Tan Beauty one. That's it. There are many other palettes I would like to buy, but I'm just resisting myself. So this one is the Perception palette. This was in collaboration with Sheila. Again, stunning palette. This palette has only 3 mattes and all are shimmers, but all the shimmers do complement those 3 mattes you have in here. And whenever I pick up this palette, I happen to create some interesting looks. Be it be a neutral golden eye look or a warmer look or a colorful look, these four mattes work absolutely stunning with all the shimmers. So she has actually included some stunning shimmers here. If you are not a person who likes to buy too many palettes, I think this is the one you can go for, which has some interesting shimmers with apt amount of mattes. So yes, this is the palette which I am enjoying the most and I have been wearing. And I must tell you, this one, the Good Sport one, another Colourpop palette, is being kept on my dressing table so that whenever I am filming a look or trying a makeup look or just getting ready to film a video, I know that I have to use these 3 palettes. That's how I am using my palettes and that's how I'm using my makeup. That's how you can also use your makeup and finish off some of your older makeup and then shift on to your new ones. So that way you can, you know, kuch paise vasool kar loge aap apne makeup ke, or else everything will expire and then you will not know what to do with it. So yes, this is another stunning palette by Colourpop. Let's move on to the last segment of this favorites, lipsticks and lip liners. Lip liners. Now yes, I have been loving lip liners lately, and yes, these are the 2 brands I love lip liners from. You already know, I really don't have to talk about them. It's K Beauty and Nykaa. Now, if I have to pick, then it has to be K Beauty. But this shade by Nykaa called Chocolate Boy has been my recent love. Oh, I really love this shade. If you're eyeing one lip liner which has little brown, a little mauve going on with the shade, try this one, Chocolate Boy by Nykaa. Amazing. Pair up with any kind of lipstick you have, deeper, lighter, berry, red. This shade complements with every shade. So I have been wearing that lip liner a lot from the time I've got it. The other 2 lip liners which I'm loving the most are by K Beauty. The first shade which I absolutely love is the shade High Impact. And the second is my recent purchase called Fame. Now both the shades are really lovely. This is the High Impact shade and this is the Fame shade. Again, lovely, stunning shades. You can pair up with any kind of lipstick you want to wear. This particular shade goes in well with all of your berry reds and mauves and pinks. And this one can be paired up with any kind of lip shade. Brown is somewhere more of a unique lip liner shade which can be paired up with any kind of lipstick. But you should always have shades like these which can complement your lighter tone lipsticks also, and even the shades which tends to wash you out a bit. If you pair those lipsticks with these kind of lip liners, they really settle down well. So yes, if you haven't tried K-Beauty lip liners, you should, because I'm absolutely in love with them. I am eyeing one more shade called Hype. I already have three of them, but Hype is again one of the cult or most selling shade. So soon I will get it and let you know how I feel about that shade too. Now we are down to the last segment, that's lipstick. Oh my god, so many lipstick I tried this month, so many reviews I've done, so many lip swatches I've done past 3 months, but these five in particular I feel I have worn the most, and I feel these are the five I've enjoyed the most during this weather also and during this lockdown time. The first one is the one I'm wearing, is by Sugar, the shade Bellatrix in the Metal Matte Liquid Lipstick. If you haven't tried this formula, haven't tried this lipstick, try one. You will absolutely fall in love with this one. This shade in particular is by far one of the best shades out of all the 10 I have felt. And there's another shade I have. I've done a full review and swatch video on this lipstick. But yes, if you're eyeing something like this, get this one. I absolutely love the formula. That is why it made it to my favorite. And I love wearing this lipstick by itself also. It looks perfectly good with and without makeup. Moving on to another lipstick formula, another lipstick addition to my lipstick collection is the Nykaa Wonder Puff Cushion Lipsticks. Oh my god, I never thought I'm going to love this lipstick, but I absolutely love the formula on this one. It comes into a very interesting packaging, the cushion packaging. Soon you will be seeing swatch. I will be getting one more shade, you will be seeing swatch, and you will be seeing a small review on these lipsticks. But yes, this is the lipstick you should try once. I would not say buy four shades, buy one. Currently they have 40% off on some shades, and this is the shade Dream On. Absolutely love this shade just because of the shade. It's again very nude, but when it dries down, it dries to a more deeper shade. So if you're eyeing something like this, get this one. It's very good. Moving on to another lipstick, and another lipstick by Nykaa Ultra Matte Lipstick in the shade Razia. This is the newest addition to my lipstick collection. I would say a newest shade to my Ultra Matte collection, shade Razia. Again, stunning shade. I don't have shades like these in my lipstick collection. I don't wear such shades a lot, but after wearing few of these, I felt that I do enjoy this kind of shade. And yes, again, a pretty stunning shade. I've done a full swatch video on my Nykaa Ultra Matte lipsticks. I will leave that in my description. Check out, I have swatched 7 shades with and without makeup. You'll know everything about it. But yes, if you're eyeing Nykaa Ultra Mattes, get any shade, you will enjoy the formula. But I have enjoyed this particular shade from the time I've got it. Now we are down to the last two lipsticks. The next one I have is the Colourbar Sinful Matte in the shade Unspeakable. Again, a nice nude shade which has too much brown happening, and a little bit of mauve is also been there in this shade. Again, very comfortable, super matte lipstick, really glides on well, pigmented, and it really gives me a nice pout, fuller lip. So if you're eyeing something like this, a little heavy on the pocket, but it's there. So get one for yourself. You will thank me later. Soon I will be swatching all of the shades I have. And last but not the least, we are down to the most inexpensive lipstick and a cult lipstick by Maybelline, the Maybelline Creamy Matte in the shade Touch of Spice. Why this lipstick? Because I bought this lipstick pretty late in my life, but I'm a big fan of this shade in general. Oh my god, I have worn this lipstick in so many of my videos with a little bit of gloss on top. It just gave me that nice nude lip. Again, very comfortable to wear in any kind of weather. So those were my monthly favorites. I hope you loved watching this interesting makeup favorites. We'll be here soon with my skincare and random favorites. Consider subscribing and following me on my Instagram. Till then, you take care and see you soon in my next one.